we have to rewrite our fraction, original fraction, to partial fractions. So how we do this? First, we need to check the power of numerator and denominator. We have in numerator x squared, and when I multiply x times x, I will have x squared in the denominator also. So first, we need to do long division. And to do this, we have to multiply x minus 3 times x plus 3. We have here difference of two perfect squares. So this is equal x squared minus 3 to second power is 9. If you don't remember the formula, let me remind you when we have a minus b times a plus b, this is equal a squared minus b squared. In our example, a is equal x, b is equal 3. So I just use this form to find our denominator. If you don't want to use this formula, you have to just multiply every term in the first parenthesis by every term in the second parenthesis and combine the like terms, and you will get the same what I have in the denominator. And our numerator we have to copy. Now we can do long division. So we have to set up first the problem. We have to divide. Let me do this here. X squared minus 2x by our divisor is x squared minus 9. How we do this? We always concentrate on the first term. And now, by what I have to multiply x squared to get x squared? By 1. 1 times x squared give me x squared. And now I have to multiply every term of our expression in parentheses by 1. So I multiply 1 times x squared is x squared. So now we have 1 times 9 is negative 9, of course, negative 9. Have to take this in parentheses, and now we have to do subtraction. So we have x squared minus x squared is 0. We don't have to write. And next we have negative 2x. And we don't have expression with x in the parentheses, so we have to copy negative 2x. And what else? Because we don't have to here constants, so it's I can add that this is like 0. So we have 0 minus negative 9. Negative and negative give me positive, so we have 0 plus 9 is 9. So we have to copy 9. And now, because the power of our remainder is less than the power of our divisor, we don't do division anymore. We can rewrite that this is equal now, whatever in we have on the top is 1 plus, and our remainder is negative 2x plus 9. We write over whatever we have in the denominator, x squared minus 9. So now when we have to rewrite our fraction to partial fractions, we have to copy this one, and we have to only change this fraction to partial fractions. So let me copy our fraction one more time. We have negative 2x plus 9 over x squared minus 9. Now we see that the power of numerator is less than the power of denominator, so this is okay. Next, we have to factorize our denominator, so we have to just copy whatever we have here. Because x squared minus 9 is x minus 3 times x plus 3. So we have negative 2x plus 9 we have to copy, and we have x minus 3 times x plus 3. Now when we factorize our denominator, we can rewrite that our fraction is equal, and now every factor becomes denominator. So we will have first fraction, partial fraction, in denominator will be x minus 3, and the second will be denominator x plus 3. And now we have to check our denominators. We have different terms, and we have linear factors because x is first powers. So when we have different linear factors in the numerators, we have only constants. So it'll be a and b we can write. And now our unknowns are a and b now. So let me copy one more time everything. So we have negative 2x plus 9 over x minus 3 times x plus 3. This is equal a over x minus 3 plus b over x plus 3. To find a and b, we have to first get rid of the numerators. How we do this? We multiply both sides by the lowest common denominator. And the lowest common denominator is always the denominator of our original fraction. So we have to multiply both sides by x minus 3 times x plus 3. Both sides. So this whole expression on the right side we have to multiply by x minus 3, x plus 3. And now we see that x plus 3 we can reduce, x minus 3 and x minus 3. So on the left side we have only negative 2x plus 9. And on the right side when we multiply every term, we need to multiply every fraction by x minus 3 and x plus 3. So what will be when we multiply first fraction by x minus 3 and x plus 3? X minus 3 will reduce. So we will have only a times x plus 3. And when the second fraction we multiply by this whole term, x plus 3 will cancel out. So we will have only b times x minus 3. So now, the easiest way, in my opinion, when we have linear factors, is to do substitution. First, we have to check what we have in parentheses. What I have to write for x to have here 0. When I put that x is equal negative 3, negative 3 plus 3 give me 0. A times 0 is 0, so I will not have this whole term with a. Only unknown will be b. And when I write for x 3, I will have 3 minus 3 give me 0. So b times 0 will be 0. So the second term will reduce for x equals 3. So this is the easiest way, in my opinion, to find a and b. Let me do this. When x is equal negative 3, what will be? I have to substitute every x in our equation now by negative 3. So we have negative 2 copy, and in parentheses will be negative 3, and we have plus 9. This is equal a times negative 3 plus 3 times b times negative 3. Negative 3 we have in parentheses. Negative times negative give me positive. 2 times 3 is 6 plus 9. This is equal a times 0. Negative 3 plus 3, like I said before, is 0. So we have b times negative 3, and negative 3 is negative 6. 6 plus 9 is 15. This is equal a times 0 is 0. We don't have to write, so we have only on the right side b times negative 6. So now we will divide both sides by negative 6. To find b, so this is equal negative 6, negative 6 we can reduce, and we have 15 and 6, so we can reduce by 3. 15 divided by 3 is 5, 6 divided by 3 is 2, and we have positive over negative, so it will be negative. So b is equal negative 5 over 2. We found b. Now we need to find a. Like I said, when we now substitute x by 3, this term will reduce and we will find a. Our unknown will be only a. So for x equals 3, we will have to our equation now x's we need to substitute by 3. So we have negative 2 times 3 plus 9. This is equal a times plus 3 in parentheses plus b will be -3 minus 3. 2 times 3 is 6, positive times negative, so it'll be negative 6 plus 9. This is equal a, 3 plus 3 is 6, b we have 3 minus 3 is 0. Negative 6 plus 9, so this is equal 3. This is equal a times 6. B times 0 is 0, we don't have to write. So now I will divide both sides by 6 because we need to find a. So 6 and 6 can reduce. And 3 with 6 will be 1 over 2. 3 divided by 3 is 1, 6 divided by 3 is 2. So we have that a is equal 1 over 2. We found a and we have b. So now we can write that our original fraction, we have to copy our original fraction, x squared minus 2x over x minus 3 times x plus 3 is equal, we rewrite our example that this is equal 1 plus this whole fraction. So we have to copy 1 plus, and now we will write our fraction to sum of two partial fractions. We found a, so we substitute a by 1/2, and the numerator we copy x minus 3, and b we found that this is negative 5 over 2, and with the numerator we copy. This is equal, we can rewrite. 1, we have to copy. We have fraction in the numerator, so I can take this 2 to the numerator, so it will be plus 1 over 2 times x minus 3. Positive and negative, so it will be negative. And again, we have fraction in the numerator, so I will take this 2 to the numerator, so we have 5 only in numerator over 2 times x plus 3. This is my solution.